Hey guys, it's Hannah. I am here to do a book tag. So we're going to do the Creatures of the Night book tag. I know it's after Halloween, but I just wanted to do it. And so I did. So it's still fall time. There's still like creepy crawl people everywhere. So let's get right into it. So for the Creatures of the Night book tag, it was created by Cattytastic, and I will link her video down below. And so what you have to do is you have to pick, she had a list of all these creatures, and you pick the creature and then a favorite book that that creature was in. So, yeah, again, let's just get into it. So the first creature is a vampire. For vampire, I chose Simon Lewis. I know that this is the first one, but, you know, you should have read this by now if you didn't know that, but Simon turns into a vampire, and he's actually pretty awesome, and I actually like him better as a vampire. He can be the first hipster vampire. Super cool. Setting trends. I'm gonna do that. Alright. Next creature of the night is a werewolf. And for my favorite werewolf, of course, I had to go with Remus Lupin from Harry Potter. I mean, again, if you haven't read this, you should have read it by now. So yeah, Remus Lupin, of course, we all love him, he saves everyone, and he's just my favorite werewolf, even though he does put people in danger at the end. But it's not his fault, you guys. Full moons, they're dangerous. Stay away. Remus Lupin. The next creature of the night is a zombie. Zombies, I chose so World War Z by Max Brooks, and if you guys have seen the movie, it's not even close to what the film or what the book is. The book is actually super cool and super intense, and it's just a whole compilation of stories from first person experiences in different places around the world where the zombie apocalypse happened. So it starts off with like the doctor who went to see patient zero, and then one of the astronauts who's really old now, and he was stuck in the International Space Station for 3 years while the zombie apocalypse was happening. People who are celebrities and lived in, like, this mansion, and then actually got attacked by people because they wanted to live there because it was safe. And it's just, you guys, it's just really good, and it's really, like, it messes with your mind because the things are so realistic that you're like, oh my gosh, this is gonna actually happen, and it might, and this is a thing. So yeah, zombies. Awesome. So the fourth creature of the night is a ghost. Ooh. For that book, I chose a book that I haven't read yet. It's on my TBR though. And it is Anna Dressed in Blood. This is about a ghost hunter named Cass, and he has traveled the towns of the world trying to hunt down ghosts so that he can make the world safe because a ghost has killed his father. And he comes to this town that has this house in it, which there is a ghost named Anna Dressed in Blood, and she kills everybody who steps over the threshold. Just your average boy meets girl, girl kills people story. Cool. Next creature, not entirely creature, but is a spellcaster or witch or wizard or magic doer. And for this book, I chose one that probably not a lot of people have heard of, but it's so amazing, and I just read it this summer, and I would pick Harry Potter, but, you know, everyone picks Harry Potter. So I'm going with The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss. The second one is The Wise Man's Fear, which is right up there, and it's just, it's so amazing. It is a little bit intimidating, and but it's so easy to get into. Like, once you start reading it, you can't stop, because Patrick Rothfuss's writing is just so captivating. It's about a man named Kavoth who has a big history, and right now he is cavorting as somebody else, so he's pretending to be a innkeeper, and somebody has come who knows who he is, a chronicler, and so he tells his story to the chronicler. So you're hearing about his life story, and the brand of magic that they have, that Patrick Rothfuss has created in his world, is so awesome because it's not unexplainable, and it's not just magic. There's a science to it, which I am not a science person, and I'm not a math person, but it's so cool to hear about. It's called Sigildry. And you get to actually, like, know exactly what they're doing, and the way that he describes it is just so awesome. And, yeah. So, read it. The next creature we have is a fairy or fae, and you guys know that I love this book, this series, so I chose Air Fire, well, the Throne of Glass series, because, spoiler, not talking, but there is fae in this series, and it's just, oh my god, you guys, it's so cool, and it's so intense, and Selena Sardothian is just intense and awesome. I'm not gonna, I can't do it justice. You just have to read it, not to mention those gorgeous covers. So, alright. Yeah. The next creature of the night is a demon. And not a whole lot of books that I read have demons in them, but I chose Aragorn and Durza particularly. I know that he's not a full-fledged demon, but he is a demon spawn. And he's creepy and evil. Yeah, so Aragorn from the Inherited Cycle, it's Aragorn, eldest something, Ember Singer. Yeah. Yeah. But it's really good if you guys haven't picked it up. It's got dragons and sword fighting and medieval times and magic and craziness, and it's so good. So, again, pick up that as well. Next creature we have is angels. And again, I don't think I've read that many books with angels in them, but I decided to go with the Clockwork series / the Mortal Instruments series. That we have Raziel and Athoriel, and they're all part angel, and they have angel blood in them because they're demon hunters, and they're shadow hunters. So yeah, angels. Ah, and next creature of the daytime. Breaking rules here. Aliens, I chose The Fifth Wave, and this book is about to become a movie, so if you haven't read it yet, you should, because it's about to become a movie, and Chloe Grace Moretz is playing Cassiopeia, / Cassie, the main character, and it's just full of action, and there's a romance in here, and it's just so good, and it's not... Rick Yancey just does such a great job creating a dystopian world where things happen, and there's just such great character arcs, and all of the plot twists and everything is just grabs you in. And the second one just came out, it's called The Infinite Sea, and my friend is reading it right now, so I haven't read it yet, but yes. Aliens. And the last creature of the time that is now, or in the past, or the future, is superhumans, or humans with superpowers, and instead of comic books, we want to talk about books. So I chose the Shatter Me trilogy. This is Unravel Me because this one's one of my favorite books, because the characters are so cool, and they just have powers, and they're not like the ones that you would, you know, they're not like comic book powers, like laser vision and flying. I mean, there's like invisibility and being able to, like, read people's minds, and just having cool powers. And this girl, like, the main character, Juliet, she kills everybody that she touches, and it's just, it's awesome. And Tahar Mafi has such an amazing writing style. It's like reading poetry, but wonderful, action-filled, sassy poetry that is awesome. And my favorite, like, sidekick character friend is Kenji, definitely from these books is Kenji, because he is hilarious and sarcastic and all around awesome. Superpowers. Alright guys, so that's all we have for the Creatures of the Night book tag. I hope you enjoyed, hope you liked it, and if you did, then keep watching. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I will talk to you next time. Bye!